ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை 23rd பாசுரம். மாரிமலை முழஞ்சில் மன்னிக் கிடந்துறங்கும் சீரிய சிங்கம் அறிவுற்று தீ விழித்து வேரி மயிர் பொங்க வெப்பாடும் பேர்ந்துதறி மூறி நிமிர்ந்து முழங்கி புறப்பட்டு போதருமா போலே நீ பூவை பூவண்ணா உன் கோயில் நின்று இங்கனே போந்தருளி கோப்புடைய சீரிய சிங்காசனத்திருந்து யாம் வந்த காரியம் ஆராய்ந்தருளேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் ஹஸ் ரீச்ட் கிருஷ்ணாஸ் பேலஸ் அண்ட் ஹஸ் சக்சஸ்ஃபுல்லி அரவுஸ்ட் ஹிம் ஃப்ரம் ஹிஸ் ஸ்லீப். த லார்ட் ஹாஸ் ஓப்பன்ட் ஹிஸ் ஐஸ் in the very manner that Andal and her friends instructed him to do so. Because the Lord is so fond of his devotees, he likes to take instructions from them, though he is the instructor of the universe, known as Niyamakan. Still, he will behave as though he is the one who listens, who is obedient, and wants to take instructions from his devotees. So, being impressed with the way that these girls gave him instructions in the previous pasuram, the Lord asks them that, what further do you instruct me to do? What do you want me to do at all now? So these girls say that we have something to ask of you, but we would like to ask in an official fashion. We want you to get up from this bed of yours and come and occupy the royal throne, so that we can ask whatever we want to in that official scenario. So the Lord says, okay, so you want me to get up and come. Do you have any specifications as to how I should get up and walk and come? The girls say, yes, of course. We would really tell you how we enjoy the way you get up from the bed and the way you walk. You resemble the lion to us, O Lord. So, you must get up like a lion, she says. And how the lion was sleeping, that also she specifies. It seems that at the time of rain, when it is rainy season, these lions do not come out of their den. They are sleeping, and they are sleeping throughout the season. They consume whatever food that they have available in the nearby vicinity, and they do not actually roam around actively hunting for their prey. So they behave lethargic and they are generally sleeping all the time during the rainy season. Once this rainy season is over, then these lions come out of their den. So Andal is saying, we would like you to get up like that and come with that gait. So she says, Mari malai muranjil mannikidandurangum. O Lord, you have been sleeping like the lion sleeping in its den in the rainy season. Mari refers to the rainy season. Malai muranjil means mountain cave or the den of a lion. Mannikidandurangum, the lion which is sleeping very peacefully without knowing what is happening around. Lord, you are like this, the lion who was sleeping inside his den during the rainy season. Mari malai muranjil mannikidandurangum. And once this rainy season is over, then the lion gets up. So you also get up like that, O Lord. Siriya singam, she says. Meaning, showing all your style, you get up and come. The way a lion gets up from its sleep, or the way a lion gets up itself, is very, very majestic and beautiful to look at. So she's saying, you come like that, Siriya Singam. And then she goes further to describe how and all the lion behaves as it gets up. And that would also suit you, my Lord, because once upon a time you came as the lion faced Lord, Narasimha. So in the Narasimha Avatara, when Hiranyakashipu struck a pillar of his palace, O Lord, you came out that day. And that was like a lion coming out from its den after sleeping throughout the rainy season. So that day you came out with so much beauty and vigor. We just want you to come out like that today also. Come out of your bed like that today also. So remembering the Narasimha Avatara, Andal describes how and all a lion behaves as it gets up, and she's instructing the Lord to behave in the same fashion. So once this lion gets up, Siriya Singham, what happens? It becomes aware of the surroundings. Arivutru, Thivilithu, and it opens its eyes. As it opens its eyes, it seems as though it is scorching the one whom it is looking at. This is how Lord Narasimha looked at Hiranyakashipu that day, because Hiranyakashipu had harmed his dear devotee Prahlada. The Lord's dear devotee Prahlada was subject to terrible harm by Hiranyakashipu, and so the Lord was really angry with him, and he gave that angry look that day, which was like fire scorching him. So Andal says, like that, you open your eyes and come, so that anybody who is doing wrong in this world gets corrected by that fire of purity. She says, Thivilithu, open your eyes, as if they are scorching the enemies or the vices. And then you get up and come. As a lion gets up, it shakes its body, and in that shaking, the mane of the lion gets rearranged. Like, once the hair and the mane shakes and then it falls back into place. So this kind of movement of the mane is a sight to look at. She's describing that. Verimayir ponga veppadum perndu udari. As the lion shakes its body, udari, all its hairs are moving up and down. Verimayir ponga veppadum perndu udari. A particular aroma comes out as it's shaking its mane, because it's been lying around in the den for such a long time. So when it gets up and shakes its body, it seems an aroma is released out of that. So also, O Lord, that day when you came out as Narasimha, you shook your mane, and as you shook your mane, a great fragrance of the Tulasi came out from you. Just proving that the Lord had come. That is, Narasimha was Narayana himself, because it was a unique form which the Lord hadn't taken before that avatara. So, probably somebody would have had a doubt whether it was Lord Narayana. To prove that, he gave out his own typical signature fragrance of Tulasi to prove that Narasimha is Narayana himself. So, like that, you get up shaking your body, and we would love to see that kind of movement that your divine body undergoes as you get up from the bed. We want to enjoy that beauty of yours, Lord, as you get up. And as you get up, you also are going to shed off all your laziness. Muri nimirndu means shaking the body so that the lethargy goes away. The scientists say, as you stretch your arms and legs after a lazy sleep, then all the lactate reserves get released and you start getting energy. So, to become energetic and save the devotees, O Lord, please come leaving away all your sleepiness. Moorini mirndu. And do not come silently, O Lord. Please make an announcement that you are coming. Mudangi purappattu. Just like the way a lion roars as it comes out of the cave, so also you must make an announcement that you are coming. People should know that you are walking out and coming for our sake. Because that is how you did when you had taken the Narasimha Avatara too. It seems Lord Narasimha gave out a big roar in which Hiranyakashipu got a massive heart attack. And this itself was enough to take out all the strength of Hiranyakashipu. Then the Lord fought a very timid Hiranyakashipu, it seems. His very roar had humbled Hiranyakashipu to the maximal extent. So, that kind of roar, that kind of announcement to the world that I am here to protect my devotee, you must give for our sake, O Lord. Murangi purappattu. Please make that roar and come for our sake, she says. and you come walking also like the lion. Take footsteps and walk to the throne, and as you walk, your gait must be like that of the lion. Podaruma pole, she says. Aruma means lion. You must look like the lion as you walk. In fact, the Lord has a gait like the lion, it seems. In the Rama Avatara, he is described to be the one with the elephant gait. Gajasimhagati veerau shardula vrishabhopamau, they say. The Lord has gaits like different animals, out of which the lion is the most beautiful one. And so, please show your lion-like gait and come and sit on the throne, Andal says. So also, Lord Narasimha had come and walked up to the throne after slaying Hiranyakashipu. And it seems he sat on the throne of Hiranyakashipu so that it becomes auspicious for Prahlada to sit later and for him to rule the world. Like that, he purified the throne by walking up to it and sitting on it. So, that kind of grace we expect from you, O Lord, for our sake too. These girls call out to the Lord and tell him to come and walk up to the throne like the Nrisimha Avatara. Now, all that Andal has described has been recorded in Srimad Bhagavatam as Shuka Brahma Maharishi describes the Narasimha Avatara, and this is very crisply told by Swami Vedanta Deshika in his Kamasika Ashtakam. He says, Satapatala Bhishane Sarabhasattaha Sodbhate Spurat Krudi Parisputat Drukudikepi Vaktre Krute Kripa Kapatake Sarin Danujadim Bhadattastana Saroja Sadrisha Drisha Vyati Vishajyate Vyajyate. All these descriptions of how the Lord came out of the pillar like a lion, how he shook his body and his mane, and how he looked at Hiranyakashipu with scorching eyes, and how he made that great roar which caused Hiranyakashipu to have a massive heart attack. All this is described in this beautiful shloka. And Andal was Swami Vedanta Deshika's greatest acharya or role model whom he wanted to always follow. So, having put Andal's word in the Sanskrit verse, Swami Deshikan pays obeisance to her. And so, Andal has described how the Lord should get up like Lord Narasimha and come and sit on the throne. As we expect you to be like Narasimha, O Lord, do not think that we are wrong people or we have vices. Because Lord Narasimha took the avatara to slay Hiranyakashipu. Is that so? Did he actually take the avatara to slay Hiranyakashipu? No. He took the avatara to save Prahlada. As we had already said, the Lord takes incarnations to save his devotees first. That is the primary agenda. Paritranaya sadhunam. To save the virtuous ones is his main agenda. So he had come to save Prahlada. And so, despite being so terrorizing to Hiranyakashipu, he was very, very tender and soft towards Prahlada. As tender and soft as a flower. So that kind of tenderness we expect from you, O Lord. Nee poo vai poo vanna, she says. You should be like the poo vai poo to us. Poo vai poo is known as Atasi Pushpa or Uma Pushpa. It is dark blue in color, and it seems the color of the Lord resembles this poo vai poo. So Andal has mentioned that the Lord should come in the form of poo vai poo. She denotes that is the color of the Lord, and also his nature should be soft as far as we are concerned, because we are his devotees and we only want to serve him. So, unko illindri ingane pondaruli, thus walking, you come and sit into your Mahamantapa or the Sabha or the main hall where you attend to all grievances of people. Un koil nindru, she says, koil is temple, or the sabha or mahamantapa where the Lord would come and sit to listen to the people's claims and grievances. So she say, you come and sit there. Ingane pondaruli, please come and sit here in this beautiful throne. Koppudaya siriya singhasanathirindu, it seems this simhasana or throne is also as majestic as a lion. Koppudaya siriya singhasanam, she says. That is the lion-like throne. Simhasana itself means the throne which has lions on its sides. That itself is indicative of the majestic nature of a lion. And here Andal specifies more that a majestic simhasana which is even more majestic than the normal simhasanas should be occupied by you, O Lord, because you are the Lord of Lords, so you should have the best simhasana. Koppudaya siriya singhasanathirindu. Okay, occupy the throne and then do what? Please understand for what we have come and help us out. Yam vandakariyam araindarulelorembavai. Please assess for what we have come. Yam vandakariyam araindarul. She is saying, please understand the inner meaning of our vrata and try to understand what we are indicatively saying when we say that we want parai or drum for this vrata. So she's trying to instigate the Lord to understand her inner heart or the gist that she has hid inside herself. So the Lord very happily walks down towards his simhasana, it seems. As these girls see the Lord walk, what is their reaction? That is what would be conveyed in the next passage.